So the ad is here producing a value of R1. That is not a problem because the previous instruction is just producing R2. So the ad can write its result when it's time and when it executed in cycle 3. So it's going to write in cycle 5. Now let's look at this multiplication instruction over here. Remember, we can execute any number of instructions in the same cycle. The reason why we had to delay the add is because it actually has this dependence from R2 to R2. The multiplication is using only R3 and producing R3. Using R3 has no problem because neither the mul nor the add are producing R3, so this multiplication can actually execute in cycle 2, and then there is no problem with R3 here because there is only R1 and R2 written by the previous instructions, so this multiplication can actually write R3 in cycle 4 because it's like 2, 3, 4. Now let's look at this add here. It uses R1 and R3. The R1 it's supposed to be using is produced by this add, which executes in cycle 3. The R3 is produced in cycle 2 by the multiplication, so this instruction actually has to wait for cycle 4 because of this. Then it's going to be cycle 5 when it's in the mem stage, and it's able to write its result in cycle 6. It's going to overwrite the result from the add here, but because the add is writing in cycle 5, it's okay if we write in cycle 6, so everything is fine here. We can write in cycle 6. Now let's look at the multiplication here. It's using R4. None of the other instructions are producing R4, so it can also execute in the second cycle. It produces R4. None of the previous instructions are writing it, so we don't have to wait for anything. So we can actually write our R4 in cycle 4 as well, just like this mul here. And then finally, let's look at this add here. It's using R1 from here. It's using R4 from here. So our execution has to be in the cycle that follows the larger of these two. The larger is the cycle 4, so we have to begin our execution in cycle 5 here. At the end of cycle 5, we will have the result. Then the mem, and we can write the result in cycle 7, but we have to check, is somebody else going to overwrite it later? And that's not going to happen, because if we write here in cycle 7, we are safe. This is the latest instruction. It should do the write of the R1 at the latest time among all the other instructions. And if you look at the previous instructions, have written the results in cycle 5 and cycle 6. So it's okay if we here write it in cycle 7. So this is the solution to the quiz.